Hello students, today in this session of grammar we are going to continue with the textbook solution as only two exercise of chapter number 2 is remaining. Last two exercises are remaining that we are going to complete in this session, and after that we will start with practice worksheet. Okay, so let's start with the textbook solution. In previous class we have completed till, I guess we have completed till question number A, right? We have completed till question number A, page number 10. So today we will start with question number B, that is on page number 10. Okay, question number B, page number. Now next, write sentence in your own in your notebook to illustrate the following aspects of the possessive form of noun. What you have to make? You have to make possessive form of noun, but that is depend on the sentence. According to the sentence you have to frame a possessive sentence. Okay, for example, first one, when you use it with plural noun. Okay, when you use it, when we use possessive pronoun, or sorry, possessive form of noun with what? With plural form. Just for example, first one, the workers representative stood up to speak. Now in this sentence, can you see that we have used possessive pronoun apostrophe s? It means it indicates this possessive pronoun. Now here we are talking about workers. Now workers, it means many workers, more than one workers. So that only we have done, right? When you use it with a plural noun. So we have used plural noun and possessive, right? So in this way you have to frame a sentence. Okay, now second one, when you use it with a noun made up of more than one word. Noun or a possessive noun made, possessive case made up of more than one word. More than one word means father-in-law, father-in-law, sister-in-law, mother-in-law. So it is made up of more than one word. Yes or no? These words are made up of more than word words. So in this way we have to frame a sentence by using such possessive noun. For example, my father-in-law's passion for collecting rare paintings are well known. Okay, so what we have done, we have used more than one noun. Okay, it is made up of more than one noun. Father-in-law, one word but made in different parts, right? So like this we have to use. Now second one, when you use it with persona, with a personified object. Now when you use it with any object or anything, right? For example, phones, right? Any phones, then any other object. Okay, then also that is, in that way also we can make what? We can make frame a sentence, right? For example, the phones. Now instead of this phones, you can use other thing also, like mobiles, right? Monotonous wailing brought me out of slumber. Right? So here what we have used? We have used object. Okay, so with object you have to make what? You have to make possessive noun. Sentence of possessive noun by using object. Okay. Now next, when you use it with a word that ends with the letter S. Now some words have S in it. Right? For example, lens. It already has S in it. Right? So we cannot add S. So what we will do? At the end, we will put apostrophe S. Right? Some words are like that. That has already S in it. Right? So with such word, what we have to do? We have to use apostrophe at the end. So that will be possessive case. Right? For example, the lens adjustment is not correct. Now next, when you use it two nouns together with a conjunction between them, with two nouns, right? For example, you can take any name, Kajal and Ravi, right? Right? Like this. So with two nouns between, of course with the name you will use and conjunction. Just for example, Rohit and Vijay. So here what we have used, what we have done, this is called which case? Possessive case. Why? Because apostrophe S is there. But it is in which form? It has two nouns together by using conjunction. Okay, two nouns with conjunctions. Rohit and Vijay's new shop was inaugurated yesterday. So this is what, students, this is possessive noun. We have made sentence from possessive noun. Till 5 we have completed, 6, 7, 8 you have to try it by yourself. It can be any sentence, but it should be depend on the things that they have mentioned in the question. Okay. Now, question number A, that is let's perfect it. Now let's perfect it is related to collective noun. We have already learned about collective noun, right? But this is of quite high level. Okay. As you are in 8th standard, it's quite high level. So, we will learn about that. Fill in the blanks with suitable collective noun from the box. They have given different collective noun like anthology, archipelago, bouquet, assortment and assemble. Now you might not have heard these words, but these words can be used as collective noun in which form, for which purpose, that we are going to learn. Okay. So first one, and dash is a collection of various things. When we are talking about collection of various things, right? Collection of pictures, collection of stamps, collection of old coins or whatever, right? Paintings. When we use collection of various things, for that we use collective noun assortment. What we use? Assortment. For example, assortment of paintings. Okay? Like this. Now, second, and dash is a group of musicians, singers, dancers or actors who perform together. Means for a performer, right? It can be a musician, it can be a dancer, it can be a singer, it can be an actor, right? But when they are in group, they are known as ensemble. Ensemble. Right? Now, third. And dash is a collection of poems, plays, short stories and another literary pieces. Now when we talk about poems, when we talk about stories, right? When we talk about different short stories, moral stories or poems or any script, right? for any other essay writing, for any other literary pieces, we can use anthology. For example, anthology of poem, when there are many poems, okay, as it is collective noun. Now next, a dash is a collection of flowers arranged in a neat order. You very well know that arrangement of flowers are known as what? It is for that what we have to use bouquet, a bouquet of flower, right? So here what we will write, bouquet. Now next, and dash is a group of island. When we talk about group of island together, they are known as archipelago. Okay. Okay, students, so I hope you have understood this. Now we are going to start with question number B, that is abstract noun. Now we have already learned about how to form abstract noun from noun or from verb and adjectives. So this is very simple. So let's start. First one, Gandhiji's dash spread far and wide. Now in this they have given great. So great will change into great is adjective. So this adjective we have to change into abstract noun. So what we will use? Greatness. This is question number B, page number 11. Okay. Now next. Flies in the room can cause a good deal of irritate, it is given. So irritate will change into irritation. Very good. Irritation. Now next. We must take dash against poachers. Now act is given. So act will change into action. Now Seema lived in London for a good dash for her time abroad. Long will change into length. Now next, the clown courtyard both funny and sad dash. Express will change into expression. As I told you, abstract noun can be used by adding suffix at the end, right? T-I-O-N, S-I-O-N, this we have learned, right? Now, to tell a lie is a sign of cowardly is given, right? Cowardly will change into cowardice. Okay, students. Now, till 6 we have completed. 7 to 10 you have to try it by yourself. And students, in this question number C, right, use the given words to form a sentence in all the three cases, that is nominative case, objective case and possessive case. So this will be homework for you. You have to try it by yourself. You have to make three cases: nominative case, objective case and possessive case. You have to frame a sentence by your own, right? You have to underline nominative case, while in objective case you will underline object, right? Whatever objective case is there in the sentence, while in possessive case you will underline the possessive case. Okay, so this will be homework for you. You have to do it by yourself. Now students, in this way we have completed the chapter, as only two these questions were remaining. So this we have completed. Now I hope you understood. Now in next session we are going to start with practice worksheet chapter.